Welcome to the voice call generator presentation. Voice call generator, also known as VCG, is part of the HyperGuard family and might be acquired at any time. VCG is an add-on application that generates scheduled GSM calls or SMS messages between SIM cards allocated in the hypermedia gateway. You can use the voice call generator in order to generate incoming local calls to the SIM cards. Also, to avoid blocking SIM cards due to outgoing calls only, and also to generate outgoing and incoming SMS. Where is it installed? You can check if VCG is active in your system by accessing to the HyperGuard folder in the Hypermedia Management Console. On the right side, you will see the HyperGuard version details. In case that is not installed, contact the sales representative for your region in order to acquire this add-on. Then go to the HyperGuard folder and click on License. You will find details of the HyperGuard license version. Then in the right side, you can see where it says VCG Systems. There you will find a number next to it. That number describes the numbers of GSM gateways managed by the VCG application. And finally, next to this folder below, we access to the VCG configuration window, and this is the window that we will use in order to create different voice calls or SMS scenarios. Now, before we start making configurations to create automatic voice calls between SIM cards, I would like to review what a scenario means. A scenario is defined by an action or group of actions. In this example, let's suppose that we create an action by generating calls between a specific group of SIM cards from a single operator. And I name that action operator A. Let's say I have another group of SIM cards from another operator, to which I create a similar action and name it action operator B. So now I already have two actions and I can create a scenario named operator A B. Also, I can add a third action to make calls between both operators A and B, and name the action calls between A and B. And then in the same scenario, I can have all those three actions or as many more actions I need. Let me give you examples of different scenarios you can create. You can create in-network calls, out-network calls, when calls are generated between two or more operators, in-network SMS, out-network SMS, in-network calls plus SMS, out-network calls plus SMS. Also, we need to take in consideration that all scenarios created will run during a specific time frame. So let's start with the VCG configuration. The recommended configuration order is the following. Start first with the Model tab, second with SIM cards tab, third with Actions tab, fourth with SMS tab, and finally the Scenarios tab. Let's then start the configuration in this order. The Model tab, here we can see the GSM modules described in the system. We can see the address of each GSM card. As we know, the first GSM card uses the address 21 and is allocated in the first left side of the GSM gateway, followed by the second slot of the GSM card using the address 22 and so on. Also, next to the GSM cards, we can see the four GSM modules or ports. In order to generate better understanding, I will show you the following illustration. So, starting from the left side of the GSM gateway, the 21 address refers to the first GSM card starting from the left side, and we will find four ports or modules as we explained it before. The second card uses the address 22 with four modules, and the same explanation applies to the rest of the GSM cards. The next configuration tab is SIM cards. Here we will find the CCID numbers from the SIM cards allocated already in the GSM gateway, also the cards, ports, and SIM cards that belong to the port. Now, the purpose of this tab is to write the telephone number that belongs to each CCID right next to it. To do that, first, let's download the CCID list. Once downloaded, now you will open it and write next to each CCID number the telephone numbers that belongs to each CCID. In this case, you need to write it manually. Now, save it and upload it to the SIM cards tab. Once you do that, you will see that the old telephone numbers are automatically assigned to each CCID. Please notice that this is a manual method to enter the telephone numbers, but in case you prefer to do it automatically, then click on the right side up icon. There you will find the auto discovery application, which is able to automatically detect the mobile phone numbers of the SIM cards inserted in the gateway, using a call or SMS method. In order this to happen, at least one SIM phone number should be manually defined per each scenario for auto-discovery to succeed. This is extremely helpful whenever new SIM cards are used, and saves you the valuable time of manually entering these numbers as provided by the cellular carrier. The next configurable tab is Actions. Here we can create all the actions that can be used in the Scenarios tab. Let's add a new action. By clicking on the green button, we will open the Add Action window. Type: describe three types of actions that we can choose. There can be an action to send SMS between the SIM cards, to create calls between the SIM cards, or to make calls for a specific IVR number. The name field is where you will select a name that will describe this action. The start time determines the time when the action will start. The end time determines the time when the action will finish. Max repetition determines the number of times that a single SIM card will be used for this action. Min interval and max interval describe the random range time where this action will take effect. Min call duration and max call duration describe the random range time that a call will last. Once we have set up all these parameters, we save them and we will see our new action created. Please check a few examples of actions types based on SMS, calls, or IVR. The next configurable window is SMS. Here we will create all the SMS that can be used in this scenario. So let's add a new SMS. By clicking on the green button, we show the Add SMS window. Here, just add the message, and when you finish, click on Save, and we will see our new SMS created. We can create as many SMS we need. And finally, the next configurable tab is the Scenario window. Here, in order to create a scenario, we just combine the modules, actions, and SMS created before. So let's add a scenario. Clicking on the green button will show the new scenario window. Then in the Model tab, let's choose the ports or modules that will be part of our scenario. Very simple. Just drag and drop each module to the next window as per the example. The same thing with SMS. We choose the SMS that will power our scenario. Just drag and drop. And now we will select only the actions that will be part of our scenario. Same thing as before, as CC has drag and drop. Finally, save the changes and we will see our new scenario created. Now, to run the scenario, just click on the green button and the VCG application will start to run according to the parameters that we already established before. Once the application is running, we will see a different status icon. For this tutorial clip, we have created only one scenario. But please, notice that you may create as many scenarios as you need. Now, in order to know that a call is being executed, go to All Cells option inside Cellular Cards folder, which is inside the Monitor folder, and see the Use By VCG calls, which are being generated by the VCG application in real time. And finally, also calls generated by the VCG can be found in the VoIP CDRs anytime you will need to have a detailed report of the calls and SMS generated by the application. Thank you for following us, and if you need more information, you can visit us at www.hypermes.com or you can contact us by email.